So today's topic is about a new robot in our, what we call the low payload area, our new Delta robot, which is a completely new robot in our program. And this one fits right in into the low payload area. So now we have a very complete program of robots. Blue, the smallest one of 3 kilos, up to the very large robots of 1300 kilos. Now, if we look into the more specifics of our scalar robot, the complete model name of that is KR3, which is KUKA robot, and 3 stands for 3 kilo payload. Delta, because the robot type is, of course, Delta. And D1200 is the reach of the robot. It's diameter 1200. And I already mentioned that the payload, rated payload of it is 3 kilo. And perhaps you see that it looks a bit special. And this is because the design of this robot has high protection class, and it's actually designed to be able to exist in food with the hygiene demands that exists here. And of course, it fits into our product portfolio in terms of software integration. All these things we will dive into a little bit here. So, HM, you saw it was called D1200 HM, which is acronym for hygienic machine. That means that the whole body of this robot is actually made of stainless steel, which is temperature and corrosion resistant, and also easy to clean and disinfect. Makes it really suitable to use in the food or medical. It has an IP67 rating. That means actually that you can wash it down with a high pressure water hose. And it's built for the environmental conditions 3K22. I'm not sure you know what that is. It's actually a definition of environmental condition. And 3K22 means that it is in a temperature controlled environment, but not the dampness is not controlled. That means a typically normal indoor climate. And it comes already with a CE and UL certificate, and it's also certified for food. So it has an FDA certification and then LFGB, Lebensmittelgeschutz Gesetz, European approval for handling food. But I already mentioned it was IP67, but the fourth axis, which is the rotating axis where your tool is placed, is actually, it's also that, of course, stainless steel. But it is even a higher protection class, IP69K, which also makes it resistant to chemicals. This is because typically in the food industry, you would wash this part down with some special detergents or even alcohol. Also important for the application is that the temperature that this robot is allowed to is 0 to 45 degrees, which is a bit unusual in the robot range of all our competitors, which all very often have 5 to 45 degrees. And when talking about food handling, it's actually a very big difference between 0 degrees and 5. Now, if you look at the payload and reach, the reach and the payload, the rated payload is 3 kilos of the robot. But it's actually possible to handle up to 6 kilos with this robot. Then to go above 3 kilos, you have to start bringing down the speed. And the reach of the robot is actually a cylinder due to the geometry of the robot, like this, which is 100 millimeters across, and the lifting height is 250 millimeters. Now, also pay attention to that with any Delta robot, the bottom of this cylinder is a small space of 50 millimeters due to the reach of the arms that will face the cylinder at the bottom. It's a reach. And in the GoTo webinar panel, there's a drop-down list called handouts, and I've uploaded the data sheet for this robot there for you. So if you're interested, you can download the data sheet with these figures on it from that spot. Now, the Delta robot comes with our new controller, the KRC5 Micro, which we also had a webinar on shortly before Christmas, and the SmartPad HMM. So those of you who are familiar with our robot range, see that it's, although it's quite a different robot, the same hardware connected to it in terms of controller and SmartPad. There are some softwares which are really useful to use together with the Delta robot, but I will get back to them in a few moments. Now, if we look to the physical installation, what's remarkable with this robot is also the very small footprint. The base of the robot, which is always ceiling mounted, of course, it has a diameter of 350 millimeters. With a bolt pattern to see around it. And orderable together with the robots are actually two mounting options, which are sold as options. One is a mounting base, which you can see as the hexagonal there in to the right. And you might also want to have a ceiling in a clean environment. When you mount the robot to the roof, you want to make sure that that mounting is tight and not leaking. And then, therefore, there's an optional ceiling between the manipulator and the mounting base to as an option. All to ensure that you can achieve a clean room environment, basically. Now, the robot also has some connections on the top. And if you look at the lower picture here, you can see that the motor cable and the resolver cable between the controllers and the robot itself can be contacted, just predefined contacts. But the robot also has some additional contacts for additional resolvers. Since this is a robot that is typically used to pick in place, we also typically want to coordinate movements with moving conveyors and moving transport bags. Therefore, the robot directly has inputs for two additional resolvers, where the idea is that you're perhaps taking a product from a conveyor, which is moving at one speed and want to place it possibly on another conveyor, which is moving at another speed. Therefore, the robot comes already from the beginning with two additional resolvers. We have also made quite an effort to keep the cost of ownership as absolutely low as possible. That means from a maintenance point of view, there is no additional greasing required during the complete lifetime of the robot. The gearboxes are lifetime lubricated, so no oil exchange and the gearboxes are needed at during the complete lifetime of the robot. And the joints, the ball heads, which these robots has, which you can see fits here, for each arm are self-lubricating. Well, so no ship monthly or weekly additional lubrication is needed for these robots, which makes it quite unique in the market. Now, a typical use case for these Delta robots is that we have typically a supply of either specific or random products coming in on a conveyor belt. And very often we want to pick them, since they are randomly distributed across the conveyor belt, we want to identify them and find them in what position they are. Therefore, we use a vision system together with a robot. And then we want to select or distribute these detected products to another part of the robot. It could be in other conveyor belts or a sorting table, kitting rack. And we want the robot to select one of the products. It could be all the products on the tape or a selection if it's a random. And then, of course, place it on another position. And for to solve that, the robot can be combined with the software, which we call pick control. And I think that showing you a movie how this works is actually the best way of demonstrating that. So hang on, and we will start a small movie I have uploaded here.
Industrial intelligence.
So, this demonstrated the Delta robots together with the software used pick control, where you can see the three Delta robots in this case doing a workload sharing between themselves to be able to cope with and placing the new products in specific pattern. This is really an interesting software also, because in this example video, you saw three Delta robots were used. But this software is not limited to the use of Delta robots. Actually, we could use any of our robots. SCARA robot, small Agilis robot, a six standard six-axis robot, or even larger robot. And it could actually even have been a combination. It could have been one SCARA robot and one Delta robot. Why you would do it that way, I'm not sure, but it's quite possible. And in fact, the demo rack you saw there used in this video is actually being built here in Gothenburg at our tech center right now. So in some weeks, we will be able to show it in real life here in Gothenburg to you as well. So all of you are welcome here to have a look. It will be slightly smaller. We will only be using two robots, but the application you saw in the video, that's the one. Thereby you can have a look at both the robots and the software itself. And we will get back to you with another webinar looking into how the software works, because the software pick control not only allows you to set up these robots and distribute it, you can actually simulate your production flow here as well to ensure that you have the capacity to pick the parts you need before building your lab. And these Delta robots and the pick control is part of our what we call our pick, pack, and palletize process, typically for material handling, where it has some products, the robots we talked about today, the vision system, which is an integrated part of our robot systems, the pick control software I've mentioned, which can handle up to 10, coordinate 10 robot movements in one line, using our Delta, which is in stainless steel we already talked about, typically aimed at the food industry, or the SCARA or the small six-axis robots, which are not food stamp on them yet. And of course they're also palletizing with a special palletizing software. And these robots are actually built or existing in sensitive pick and place environment. That could be direct food handling or food processing, pharmaceutical industries, whatever life science, medical applications, and clean room environment for the electronic industry.
Industrial intelligence.